Welcome to the Fredbear's Family Diner rebranding concept for all chain locations. In this tape, you will be provided with the necessary information to complete the renovations of the show stage area. If you have any further questions about the replacement of the show, you can refer to page 104 of the employee manual. If you need an employee manual, refer to pages 206, 207, or 1093. First, you should test out the Fredbear and Bonnie show tapes before beginning the renovation process. Reviewing the tapes will ensure that the internal components of the characters will be able to be used in the renovation process. For further instructions on running the show tape, refer to page 65 of the employee manual. We will begin by removing cosmetics of the characters, starting with Fredbear. First is hat, tie, and microphone. Head, arms, and body piece. Next, Bonnie. First, their head and tie, arms, and body piece. Now, you will begin to replace parts of the animatronics, starting once again with Fredbear. First, remove and replace Fredbear's mint upper endoskeleton with a structurally improved set that was provided by the manufacturers. Set the Freddy Fazbear body piece where the Fredbear body piece once was. Place Freddy's arms on their respective sides. Place Freddy's head over the new endoskeleton head. And finally, correctly place his hat and bow tie. That's real great. Now, you will be replacing parts of Bonnie. First, remove and replace Bonnie's mid to upper endoskeleton with the structurally improved set that is provided by the manufacturers. Set the Bonnie piece where the original Bonnie piece once was. Place Bonnie's arms on the respective sides. Place Bonnie's head over the new endoskeleton head. Okay then, now all that's left to do is to place the characters in their proper locations. Building updates and stage props will be covered in a future tape. Place Chica to Freddy's right. Remember, Fazbear Entertainment may request a certain arrangement if necessary. Installing Pirate's Cove will be covered in another tape. Congratulations, phase one of the rebranding process is now complete.
Hello there. While you're on your way, I'll go over the plans beginning again, just so that we can do this quickly. Once you get there, go straight to the security room as you were assigned to do by the company. After watching over the cameras for a little bit, start shutting off the cameras and audio system, as displayed on the camera system itself. The animatronics in there act as security, so if any wander into your office, hide underneath the desk, since they shouldn't be able to detect you at that point. However, there is a prototype endoskeleton character somewhere in the facility, so make sure that you look out for it. It should be light-sensitive, so make sure that you could direct a light at it upon seeing it. Alright, I'll go over the rest of the plans again once you've gotten far enough. Let's do this.
Thank you. Hello there. Welcome to the interactive control tape for Fazbear Entertainment Animatronics. I'm Freddy Fazbear, the lead singer in the group. You have to make sure that I'm heard around the establishment, and I don't mess up my performance during the show. It works just as if I'm a puppet, except that I don't have an arm coming out of me. Instead, I need to look as alive as ever, so you need to make sure I don't go dying on ya. Now, let's look at my control rig. On the control rig, you will find three main function sets just for movement in between shows. On the right side of the controller, you will see a control set for my head. Go ahead, try opening my jaw. Great, now, on the left side of my controller, you will find a controller for my main body piece. Go ahead, try moving my body forward. Excellent, on the middle of the controller, you will find a few preset actions for me. Go ahead, make me laugh. Terrific. Control training is now complete. Now you should be ready to make the pizzeria come to life.
Good job. The first set of security animatronics should have been deactivated. Now, head to the storage room, which is behind the first door you see in that dark hallway. There are some items that we have seen within that facility from the pictures taken, so hopefully they just happen to still be there. Collect them and try to go through the door on the right side of the storage room. Once you've gotten through, I'll contact you again. Good luck.
welcome to the Arcade Room Maintenance Training Tape. In this tape, we will be going over how to test and set the arcade machines out for repair if necessary. Two arcade machines will be demonstrated in this tape as examples of the maintenance work. First, let's test out this arcade machine. Looks like that game worked perfectly. Now, we will test out a game of questionable quality. Arcade machine died. Let's make sure that is sent out for repair. Great job. Arcade room training is now complete.
Performer/Entertainer for Freddy Fazbear's Pizza. These tapes will provide you with much-needed information on how to handle/climb into/climb out of mascot costumes. Right now, we have two specially designed suits that double as both animatronic and suit. So please pay close attention while learning how to operate these suits, as accidents/injuries/death/irreparable and grotesque maiming can occur. First, we will discuss how to operate the mascots when they are in animatronic form. For ease of operation, the animatronics are set to turn and walk towards sound cues. This is an easy and hands-free approach to making sure the animatronics stay where the children are for maximum entertainment/crowd-pleasing value. To change the animatronics to suit mode, insert and turn firmly the hand crank provided by the manufacturer. Turning the crank will recoil and compress the animatronic part around the sides of the suit, providing room to climb inside. Please make sure the spring locks are fastened tight to ensure the animatronic devices remain fixed. We will cover this in more detail in tomorrow's session. Remember to smile, you are the face of Freddy Fazbear's Pizza. For today's lesson, we will be continuing our training on proper suit handling techniques. When using an animatronic as a suit, please ensure that the animatronic parts are tightly compressed and fastened by the spring locks located around the inside of the suit. It may take a few moments to position your head and torso between these parts in a manner where you can move and speak. Try not to nudge or press against any of the spring locks inside the suit. Do not touch the spring locks at any time. Do not breathe on the spring locks. Thank you.
Hello there. Today's lesson will be going over springlock suit cleaning. Part of Fazbear Entertainment's motto is being clean with a bit of sheen. They really need to work on that one, but you know, safety and cleanliness comes first. So, first of all, make sure that you have correctly separated the suit parts, as shown in the diagram on page 124 of the employee manual. Make sure that you also have the parts laid out on a table, where you should be able to easily clean the parts. Cleaning the parts is a simple task, really. Just start out by getting a can of our recently manufactured fast spray, which can slowly soak and sparkle the suit over the time span of about 6 hours, just in time for the next morning. So go ahead and start spraying the suit, making sure that no electronics were left inside of the suit after removal. Great job, rookie. In the next tape, we will be covering how to safely exit the suit. Oh, and remember to smile, you're the face of Freddy Fazbear's Pizza.
Ha 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 ha.